Well, welcome once again to our Wonderful Day in the Lord broadcast. We've been working for several weeks now on the subject of the riches that we have in Christ. And we're going to continue that this week, looking at a number of other riches that are ours. There's so much in the Word of God that tells us of our blessings in Him, all that are ours in Jesus Christ. And it's good to be reminded of that once in a while. We tend, at least a lot of us do, we tend to gravitate towards the difficult things in life and maybe get despondent over the difficult problems we're facing or whatever. And we tend to forget the blessings and the riches and the treasures that are ours in Christ. And so the New Testament doesn't forget that, and it constantly reminds us of who we are in Jesus Christ. And if we are reminded by the Word about that, it's so very helpful in our own lives. And so we're going to look at several this week. The first one is in 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 9, one of my favorite verses in Scripture. It says this, "But you are a chosen family, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a people for God's own possession, so that you may proclaim the excellencies of Him who has called you out of darkness into His marvelous light." And then in verse 10, it says, "For you were once not a people, but now you are the people of God. You had not received mercy, but now you have received mercy." Beautiful passage of Scripture. Last night in our Wednesday night service, we had a missionary we supported for 29 years to Mongolia, and he spent about 20 minutes talking about the fact that the Lord is at work calling out a people for Himself. And that is primarily what He is doing. He is calling out a people from every tribe and tongue and nation as a people for Himself. And this passage of Scripture speaks of that very clearly. And what a teaching here. Look at that. We're a chosen family, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a people for God's own possessions. We belong to God. We are the possession of Almighty God. What a thought that is. You know, I have some things in my possession at home that I might call trinkets. I got a small suitcase full of stuff. I got a little box with some really, really small trinkets that have meant something to me over my lifetime. These are things that go back to my youth or my high school days or whatever that remind me of things that are very, very special to me. These things belong to me once in a while, very rarely, but once in a while, I'll look at those things and be reminded of some special memories. But when I'm gone, my boys will care less about those trinkets and those memories because they don't have those memories. Those things don't belong to them, and therefore they really don't care. And so when I'm gone, they will probably just throw them in a garbage can somewhere. If they would keep them, it would have no value to them at all because it means nothing to them. So to think that we're special to God because we belong to Him, and that reminds us of how blessed we are to even think that we could actually belong to the Lord Himself. Then he goes on in that same verse, one of the great applications and implications of the fact that we belong to God is that we have a very unique and specialized ministry and opportunity. He goes on to say in verse 9, "that you may proclaim the excellencies of Him who called you out of darkness into His marvelous light." And so because we belong to Him, we are His family, His people, He's called us out, we have a privilege of being able to proclaim the excellencies of Christ. Now, no one can do that unless they belong to the Lord Himself. And so the fact that we belong to Him, that we are His possession, that He's called us out and given us this wonderful relationship, this wonderful privilege to be part of His family, because of that, we have the opportunity to tell others of the greatness and the excellencies of Christ. And I like it, this verse. One of the reasons why this is one of my favorites is the way it says that. The other scriptures talk about how we can tell other people about Christ and give the gospel and many other wonderful things. But to say it this way is special to me, to proclaim the excellencies of Him, the excellencies of Jesus Christ. We get to tell other people that, to proclaim that. And that's because He's called you out of darkness into His marvelous light. Once you've been brought out of spiritual darkness into spiritual light, we have much to proclaim concerning the greatness of Christ and His excellencies and what he's done for us. So one of the things that we're talking about this week as far as our treasures and our riches in Christ is the very fact that we belong to Jesus Christ and we have the privilege of proclaiming his excellencies to others. I don't know about you, but that will give me a wonderful day in the Lord for a long time. We'll see another one tomorrow.